Waste management. We don't really give it the comedic attention it deserves, but in 1990, Emilio Estevez did just that with his comedic smash hit, Men at Work.
So, I don't know why, but Men at Work kind of snuck into my psyche at a weird time, like the 80s into the 90s, like a lot changed culturally. I was 15 going on 16 and starting to get into the depressive brooding phase of my teenage years while still maintaining the hilarious disposition I'm known for today. It cost $9 million to make it, made 16, not including the DVD I bought at Fry's many years ago. But it's just this bad comedic transportation-based garbage movie that is also like weirdly pro-environment at a time when like they're driving a garbage truck all over the place throughout the whole movie.
Seems to be working. Pablo is here. We're in Hermosa Beach, which is now paying tribute to jazz. We can do this, right, Pablo?
There are several sacred things in this world that you don't ever mess with. One of them happens to be another man's fries.
This is the location of the Never Touch Another Man's Fries restaurant. And the way you can pinpoint that is when you look out the window of the restaurant, you see this opposite it. So you never see exteriors of this restaurant. But it's actually a guitar place now. It used to be Globe Skateboard Shoes, and before that I think it was some kind of Cajun place, but it was formerly a diner, and now it sells luxury guitars at the beach. I think Never Touch Another Man's Fries is one of the most memorable lines from the movie, and also something that actually like transcended the movie, that people who have never seen the movie will go on and on about. And yeah, I think that's a nice little special moment. This is so corny, sorry.
Now you remember that, and you'll live a long and healthy life.
I tell you, Carl, this is the last year we throw trash. You said that.
I'm telling you, Carl, this is the last year we throw trash. He wants to smell every parking meter. Right here is approximately where the garbage truck was, where the boys got garbage from. You can see these bricks on that ledge in the background. My microphone doesn't seem to be working, so here is the garbage truck vantage point in which the golf clap situation unfolds. The garbage truck obviously made a left onto Beach Street here and stopped here to pick up neighbors' trash on either sides of the street. Right here, they were stalled. I am doing real-time recreation of a garbage truck stopping to get trash. The street is where Carl and James apprehend the dead body of the politician. It bounces into the garbage off of an alleyway right up there and is basically deposited at the next driveway. So from this vantage point, you can basically see all of these balconies in the background, that stairway. And then the We're Screwed close-up is basically from right here. Right here would be where the police officers arrive to ask about the drunk Texan in the garbage truck. And now there is a crying baby, but that lamppost is where the re-elect Jack Berger sign was.
I'm gonna end this now. The message of the movie: save the environment, drive a garbage truck, have fun with your friends on the job.